said, put your money where your mouth is. I said, put your body where my couch is. I just got the Roku TV. You know that it's jailbroke. Your baby, you please me. You laugh when I tell jokes. You gotta be goddess. Body the hottest. I'm not for the modesty. I gotta be honest. I'm shooting my shot in. I'm hoping my shot hit your Ricky the GOAT. Now I know that I got this.
Stop all that faking, I know who you really are. Stop all that shaking, I smell fear in your heart. See, you's a snake, your middle name is Lucifer. And I got facts to back it up like I'm about to rear in the car. They said,
you the one that snitched on Lil Pookie and got him.
Who is Ricky Devane? I am the man of many names. The lover boy, second son of God, the sage, anything you want to call me. But honestly, I feel like I musically am emotion personified, and with that being said, you know what I'm saying, I create a lot of music, which is coming from raw, real places in my life, a lot of real situations, and I'm not one to advocate, you know what I'm saying, having music that has one set purpose over time. Whatever I'm feeling at the moment is what I'll create, so I feel like that is me as a person.
I see you sweating hard, I know you want.
I've had a weird music journey, and it's very rock and roll now that I think about it. I'm a pastor's son, so when I first started rapping, my first thing was, you know, I'm doing raw, explicit raps with my homies and stuff, and I was like, I want to take this to the next level. That's when my homie first told me about SoundCloud, so I was like, I'm going to put this music on the internet, and I don't want to put it on there with cussing because I ain't trying to get beat. So I dropped like a whole project with no cussing and people loved it. And then from then on there, I started dropping more and more projects, and each project progressed, be it with studio equipment, sound, style, flavor. It's been a pretty fun journey. I met a lot of people, cut off a lot of people. I'm just here for the ride, so you know what I'm saying. My dad was always singing to me even before I was born. And he likes to say that has a big part of my life. And I believe so too. So with him singing, growing up hearing a lot of Al Green and things around the house of that nature, got me into singing in the pre-K and things of that nature. Singing turned in a little rapping here and there, and so on and so forth. So I feel like music has always been around in my life. I had a lot of family members who were well-versed in music, so that was kind of second nature for me.
You know you're all. You're too far away. I know you ain't concerned with me.
Blind. That was a song I wrote at a very emotional period in my life. I had just went through a breakup with a girl very close to me. I had never been this vulnerable to anybody in my life, you know what I'm saying? And when she left, that kind of happiness or the euphoria that came with the relationship left, I was like thrown into this depression. So I made this song kind of reaching out for her.
Yeah, you know my love is blind, baby.
Kid Cudi. Man, Kid Cudi was like the saving grace in my life. When I felt so alone, I felt like he was the only person. When I found his music, it was like he was the only person on this planet who understood me. So for me, I wanted to be that person in other people's lives, you know what I'm saying? I wanted to be that voice to let people know that, you know what I'm saying? Oh, you're not the only one suffering from deep heartache. You're not the only one suffering from, you know, mental problems and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? I don't want people to feel alone. I guess that's what motivates me. And I just like having fun. So I like putting things out that heightens people's moods, and or depending on my own, it would probably lower theirs. But like I said, I like having this responsibility of controlling people's emotions, and that's what motivates me. Most of the time, because I do like to produce now, where I'll find producers who have amazing, amazing styles, their own individual styles. What I'll do is I'll hear that, and this is what a lot of people do, or a lot of the good rappers that I know do, is just na 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 na, or like feel out the rhythm of the song. Then we'll go through and put in things that actually have meaning to it, you know what I'm saying? Now, content-wise, most of the things that I do write about is, you know, life-based, or aspiration-based, like goals that I have for the future, or heartbreaks that I'm going through now, struggles that I'm dealing with in daily time. Now, I don't want to give the impression that I'm only making music like, oh, I had a hard life and things of that nature, but, you know what I'm saying? I like to make music based in reality. I feel like I'll always be two steps ahead of everybody, even if we're walking next to each other. And what that means is I'll always have a certain it factor over the next guy. And I don't want to sound cocky while saying that. It's just something that I've learned over time, which it is, you know what I'm saying, it's about me. There's a legend when I'm gone. I might die today. I might live for. I feel like, I hate to be that guy, but I do feel like I'm one of those few people that are destined for greatness. So that kind of drives me into, even if I don't want to do something, oh, I have to do this. Even if I'm too shy to do something, oh, you're going to have to do this anyway. It's all a part of the bigger plan. It's all a part of the bigger picture. So I feel like my sense of destiny, or my sense of what's meant to be, is what drives me. She ain't for the mosh pit, so baby, we could cruise around the city, you could chill in the cockpit. I got a couple tapes to pop in. You want an adventure, baby girl, so hop in. As soon as we hop out, act like you on red carpets. Pose for the camera, baby. Stop it. Well, can I take you shopping? I just got a rack for a show. I was hoping to drop it. I'm usually locked in. She didn't have a key to my heart, but somehow she went and got her a locksmith. And baby, I like that. She started acting feisty. Well, baby, I bite back. She love when we play fight. Throw all around and physically and mentally. My hood. And I'm doing less than I should, but that's still more than you got. I think I'm waiting, nine. Lil Ricky, keep the block hot. They say you only get one shot. Well, I'ma load it up and cocky, let it bang like guac.